Hi class, welcome to another lecture on CS575. We continue with the box Jenkins methodology. So let us take a just 30 seconds wrap up. So we have the three phases for identifying, fitting and checking ARIMA models. First we identify whether the time series is stationary or non-stationary. Then we estimate and finally we do the forecasting. So first step, identification. So that involves part A and B. So we have first is data preparation. In that we basically transform the data to stabilize variance. Now, as we know, for a stationary time series or a stationary data, we have a constant mean and a variance, right? Stabilizing variance means if it does not have a constant variance, we need to make it constant. Then differencing data to obtain stationary series. As we know, differencing is one of the very famous methods. So you can have logarithmic difference, simple differencing. We have various other differencing methods also to make the time series stationary, right? Again, this is by trial and error. There is no direct method to see whether you can difference and get the stationary time series in one attempt, two attempts, three attempts. Second is model selection. So we examine the data, whatever time series we have, we take the autocorrelation function and partial autocorrelation. So again, once again, reiterating autocorrelation function and partial. Let us see first partial one because it is easier to compute and remember. Partial means, for example, if you are taking a time series X and let's say you have the lagged version, you have 7 lags here. So you just take these two time series and compute the partial autocorrelation. Now, why it is called partial? Because we don't, this is X of 0, the original time series, and this is lagged by 7. So when we consider partial autocorrelation functions, we neglect the intermediate x1, x2, x3, x4, x5, x6. All the effect of all those lagged versions are neglected in partial. And hence it is called partial because we do not take the intermediate values. As against this autocorrelation functions, we take the complete effect. So when we have x0 to x7, we consider all the intermediate values also. Right, so identification, two main steps. Now let us go to the next slide. Second is estimation. So estimation means you need to estimate the parameters in the potential model. For example, ARIMA has three parameters, P, D and Q. We check for the various values of these models and select the best model using suitable criteria. So one of the criteria here which we normally use is the AIC criteria, which we will see later in more details. The lower the value of AIC, the better the model is. Then diagnostics. Then we say check ACEF and PCF of residuals. Residuals means, for example, so let's say this is your time series and this red one is the predicted version of your time series. So what does residual say? For example, if I see here, let me have another ink color. Hope it's visible. So if you see at this particular point, right, so this was my original data, right, this was the blue one is my original data and this one is my predicted data, the red one is predicted, right? So ideally when I predicted this model, this value should have come here at this particular point, but due to some error in the forecasting and all, there is a difference here between the original and the predicted. So this difference of value basically is known as the residual, that is what is left over. So this means that we take all the residual. So for example, if you have 100 points in the series, so we know the original points and then we forecast our model and we can difference each value with each other and get 100 points. For those 100 points, we again need to compute the ACF and PCF just to see for particular relations between them. And then there is another portmanteau test. We are ignoring this for this particular lecture. And are the residuals white noise? So white noise again have a constant mean and variance. And third part is application. So used to forecast the model, right? So once you are decided on the parameters and everything, now you basically model, right? And you apply basically the values of PDQ on the given problem statement and try to forecast with minimum error. So class, that was just a basic introduction to the three main steps in Box Jenkins methodology. So I stop this video and the other lectures will be following.